All I'm asking is the truth. If you take the blue pill, you can remain sick and continue to go to your doctor each day. Or I'm offering you the red pill, which will take you down Alice's wonderland of rabbit hole of reality. Wait. There's probably an essential for that, though. Let's take a look at your question. I'm just kidding, you guys. If you've seen The Matrix, you know what I'm talking about.
Well, Dorothy from Brooksville, Florida writes, Rebecca, I'm very excited about essential oils and would like to start using them regularly and start getting away from the prescription drugs I'm taking. How should I go about doing that?
Oh, wow. Well, first of all, I want to recommend if you're, you know, seeing a doctor, you definitely want to make sure that they understand that you're looking for natural alternatives and ways to maybe minimize using prescription drugs. So you want to involve your doctor, and you also might want to consider looking into getting with a certified aromatherapist who can help you and guide you in which oils you need to use, which would be beneficial. Because we're not, you know, again, this is not a magic pill, magic bullet. This is just to enhance your body and help assist your body to build up its immunity, help support it in the healing process. And so that's really what essentials do. It's not like, you know, going to make it all go away, disappear for you. There's certainly going to be people who need to continue to take their medications, follow the doctor's directions.
So it's a lifestyle change.
It really is. It's part of your lifestyle. You just need to sort of slowly incorporate them into your life. Try to see what works and what doesn't work for you.
Okay, yeah. Let's go to the next one. Ginny in Midlothian, Virginia writes, I have a problem with insomnia and I really hate the sleep aids I've been buying. I'm looking for a more natural way of getting to sleep at night. Which essential oil do you recommend?
Mm-hmm. Well, Ginny, I'm from Virginia too. I'm from Richmond, Virginia. I love Virginia. I haven't been there in years, but if you are having trouble sleeping, there's several oils that you could use. Of course, cedarwood would be number one. Mm-hmm. This is going to help with your melatonin, help you sleep better at night. Spikenard is another one that's known to be a natural sedative. It'll help you calm down, help you to, you know, maybe get a nice deeper sleep and get into that dream state.
Lavender's a good one.
Lavender is a very popular oil. Most people are very familiar with that one. That's a great oil too. So I know a lot of people that have tried those, and there's probably many, many others that you could, you know, maybe go to your book and take a look and see what you find that what will work for you.
We got time for one more. Arlene in Lansing, Michigan writes, Rebecca, my son Timmy recently started first grade and the teacher had contacted me about his hyperactivity. They are suggesting I take him to a doctor to get a prescription drug for him to calm down. Is there anything I can do that requires that doesn't require the use of drugs?
Mm. Well, you know, there are a lot of school systems that are starting to become more aware of essential oils because of so many people out there talking about them now. And so they're allowing parents to bring, you know, let their children bring like an inhaler or maybe a pocket diffuser or something that they can carry with them, and that'll help them to be more calm using some of, like, say, lavender, cedarwood, obviously, as we mentioned, for ADD or, you know, the ADHD.
Doesn't cedarwood help with memory, too?
Absolutely. They had test studies that showed that not only cedarwood, but lemon and grapefruit actually increased the child's concentration. They tested higher on their, you know, their test. And so it was actually very beneficial for them. I know some teachers will diffuse oils in the classroom. Of course, they need to get permission from their parents to do that in case of allergic reactions or any kind of allergies or sensitivity to things. So, certainly.
I think that helped our son Dallas, too.
Yeah. I know that, actually, do you remember Judah, years ago, used to have the asthma.
Right.
And thank goodness we discovered the essential oils, and he was just breathing them as he was going through the home, you know, because we use them in the home all the time. And now he's perfectly fine. Mm. He's just been, you know, great. So we enjoy getting your questions. Please don't hesitate to contact us.